All the liquid nitrogen. Oh! For liquid nitrogen on 1,000 burning sparklers. Huh?
And today, we are going to be finding out what happens when you pour liquid nitrogen over 1,000 sparklers.
That's a lot of sparklers.
That's a lot of sparklers.
That's a lot of sparklers.
Also today, guys, we are going to be doing a whole ton of super, super cool experiments using liquid nitrogen.
You didn't get that joke, did you?
Cool, like, cool experiments cool, with liquid nitrogen.
Cool, like a,
you're getting funnier, cool. Dustin. You're smart, you got the fun.
Now between the experiments, we are gonna be doing my absolute favorite thing to do with liquid nitrogen.
Smashing
stuff. Now make sure you guys don't miss out on any of the other cool liquid nitrogen experiments I did on my last video. Boom, it is right there. Make sure you guys go watch it. Kick things off with a bang, I mean like a literal actual bang, and start smashing some stuff. 3, 2, 1, boom! How about, one, these weren't in liquid nitrogen yet, and two, I lost my mallet.
Yo, what's up, ladies and gentlemen?
He forgot the mallet.
Well, I forgot to tell him about this is your fault.
It is my fault. So instead of using the mallet, we are gonna use our new, bam, the can of corn. 341 milliliters of solid steel.
Solid corn. Wait, why are you pouring it into a can? I was not smart.
Here we go.
Oh.
Yep, that always happens.
Oh my god.
Now, as you can see, we got the colorful marshmallows. Because we're fun like that. 2, 1. That is marshmallow dust. Let's get a quick slow-mo. Next up, it's kind of similar to it's not similar to marshmallows, it's just, I'm just gonna show you what we're doing. This is both an experiment and a smashing experiment. Fill up some liquid nitrogen in the bowl here. Get your whipped cream.
Ooh.
Make nice little rosettes.
Oh. I'm each.
Me and Sean are gonna have a nice little cheers here.
All right.
Cheers, buddy.
Cheers.
Did you do that on purpose?
You said cheers, what do you want me to do?
All right,
cheers.
Ready? One.
I like the ice dragon.
Oh my god!
On your feet?
In case you guys are wondering, I don't usually wear socks behind here. Alright, next. Now you guys are gonna really, really like this experiment. Because, well, I know I'm really gonna like it. And I sort of think we're like each other. We don't actually need the Pepsi for this experiment, we just need the can. So what you wanna do is fill the can up halfway with water. Precisely halfway. Put it on the burner, straight to high. And now we just wait till the water boils. Bam, you guys see that water? Can they see the water vapor?
There's water vapor there though, trust us.
3.
It's gonna explode.
I'm scared. 2, 1. What? Come on! Let's try that again. While that's heating up, let's get back to smashing some stuff. And next up, we got some dinosaurs. Come with a nice little treat.
Eat it.
Now you guys know what happened to the dinosaurs, right? We got our Bronchosaurus. What's this one called?
Brontosaurus.
Were you even close to anything that could be considered a rational thought? Everyone in this room is now dumber for having listened to it.
It's like Littlefoot.
It's coming and all of a sudden it's like we got the T-Rex and then all of a sudden, boom, you know what happened to the dinosaurs?
They fell in liquid nitrogen.
The Ice Age. Somebody comment down below what dinosaur this is. Hold on, Ice Age is still going. Ice Age is still going. They rained a lot during the Ice Age. The dinosaurs were gonna come back to life. The mighty corn came and got them.
Holy, it's just his little head.
And the only dinosaur to live to tell a tale is this long headosaurus boxing. This is actually
it's like a kangaroo.
I swear to God, I was about to say that. This is the descendant of the kangaroo.
You mean the kangaroo is the descendant of that?
Facts. All right, so next up we are gonna make some ice cold bullets, shoot them at things and see if it explodes. So let's give that a shot.
That's another one.
Okay, here we go. Gonna let that sit in there for a little bit. First bullet going in.
Ooh, yeah. But that would hurt a hell of a lot more than the original version.
Another one. Whew. This is like I'm playing Guns of Boom, but in real life. You know that new mobile shooter game? It's like a real PC shooter, except it's on your phone. Check it out. Check it out. It has autofocus. Look at this.
Shoot him.
I didn't think I was gonna make it. out goes to Guns and Boom for partnering with me on this video. Download the link in the description down below and let me know what you guys think. Anyways, guys, water's boiling. Go back to the can experiment. You get your cold water. One.
Oh, I hear something.
It worked!
Hey!
Look at that! Boom! Science! We should just move on to the next one.
Yeah, I think that's time to give up.
All right, next. Boom! We got Coke bottle rockets. I'm really excited for this one, but you already know, okay, we cannot do this indoors, so let's take it outside. All right, guys, so clearly we're filming this part later at night, but I'll be back in my kitchen in just a minute. You're the bottle rocket guy. Light off some bottle rockets.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're gonna take your Coke bottle, pour out a little bit of the Coke, go about halfway. You're just gonna pour it straight in here. Now you wanna steer clear of everybody, so I'm gonna move over here. Got another Coke bottle. Try this again. We're gonna go quick.
No. Are you soaked in Coke?
Bro, I'm
oh my God. You shout out to my man, youtube.com/itsyourboy. Look at him, he's all soaked. All right, let's get back to my kitchen. We are about to do a little bit of an unboxing as well. Check this out. We are our Kinect Super Mario little Lego action figures thing. Let's see what we get. Comment down below whether you think we're gonna get Wario, Yoshi, the green block, Mario, Peach, Toad, or Luigi. I like Toad. Ooh! I like Toad. I get Toad. On Mario Kart Racing, I always played with Toad. He's the coolest.
Ooh,
Mario.
The legend.
Mario, there
can't
you
go wrong with Mario.
So one day, Toad was just walking along, came by himself. He was like, "What? What is this? I gotta go tell someone." Went and told Mario. He was like, "Yo, there's this like big geyser thing. Come check it out." Holy crap, man! Look how cool that is. That's how Mario talks, by the way. I wonder what would happen if you jumped in, and I'm not gonna jump in it. You're not gonna jump in it. Mario sells out Toad, pushes him in. Frosty Toad comes out from the depths, grabs Mario. They both go in, and now they're sizzling.
Did he just-
Oh my God!
He already broke?
Mario exploded! Toad's head exploded
Toad's
too!
Toad's head exploded!
And Mario's face! Mario and Toad Frost Edition came out, but then the big bad corn boss came to play them. Alright, next. Now, in my last video, I introduced you guys to the shrinking balloon experiment, but I decided, you know what, in my second video, I gotta step it up a little notch. Little life hack, you get these, and check this out.
Hey! Hey! Oh my God!
Put a whole bunch more, check us out, watch what happens.
Hey!
Last time we did a really cool experiment with ping pong balls where they spun around in water. It's really cool, you should go check it out. But look, this time, we're just gonna smash it straight up. All right, well there's a dent in the ping pong ball, but luckily, I know a life hack for that.
There you go. Hey!
Just like that, guys. Oh. Boom, the ping pong ball no longer has a dent. But we're gonna put a big dent in it now. Ice cold ping pong ball, super rock hard can of corn. Oh my God. All right, next, we got one of my favorite things. We got a whoopee cushion. So the question is, will a whoopee cushion still fart if it's frozen in liquid nitrogen?
Whoa, dude.
Oh my God, it's like rock hard. 3, 2, 1. I guess not. Next. Next, we're gonna find out what happens when you mix liquid nitrogen and silly string.
Oh, chill. That's how you wanna play,
eh?
I said that's how you wanna play, eh? Thought B, don't ever mess with me. I may or may not have just tested the experiment, and it was really cool.
Oh!
Frying something.
All right, so we just got some crispy silly string. Now guys, it is finally time for me to show you guys what happens when you pour a whole ton of liquid nitrogen over 1,000 burning sparklers. Now obviously we can't burn 1,000 sparklers inside here, so we're gonna go somewhere a little bit more safe. All right guys, so we're done unboxing over 1,000 1,000 sparklers. Somebody do the math. There was 18 in a pack. I had 65 packs. Do the math, please. Boom. There's that many sparklers right here. It is nighttime, so you guys can see it a lot better. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put this down here, pour the liquid nitrogen into this pan. Then I'm gonna stand on here. When the flames start to get up kind of high, pour the liquid nitrogen on it. I'm gonna jump off this thing and run like crazy because I don't know what the heck is gonna happen. All right, this really doesn't sound like a good idea.
I would say this is probably your worst idea ever.
Yeah, I'd probably agree. Am I a little scared? Yeah, I'm a little scared. Should I do this?
Yeah, you should.
Yeah, I should. We are about to find out what happens when you pour a liquid nitrogen on 1,000 burning sparklers.
What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard.
Here we go. I shouldn't be doing this. All the liquid nitrogen.
Oh!
That's a lot.
Yeah, man.
That's a lot.
Bro, that's so much. Is that gonna fill the entire thing? Yo. Good luck, my friend. I'm actually kind of shook right now. Oh my god.
You see how much smoke?
Oh yo, it's lighting the grass on fire, I think.
Did you see how quick that was?
That was insane. There was a little battle. There was a little battle.
I just left.
Yeah, that was a good call.
Oh my god. Guys, smash that like button because that was dope. Here. All right, guys, so we gotta put out this fire, but before you go, boom, boom, go check out my latest videos there. Make sure you guys subscribe to It's Your Boy.
Come on over, ladies and gentlemen, subscribe.
Big thanks to my man, Kevin, for letting me burn his yard. Super happy I survived another experiment so I can once again leave on a high note.